way now to view a venue for a women's reproductive health program I'm trying to plan. Really passionate about it and very frustrated right now just because I'm running late. And it was just a really crazy morning. And I'm really realizing different things that trigger me and things that I have to put in place in order to protect my sanity and to protect my well-being, you know, at the end of the day. And so, yeah, today's just a crazy day. So last night, the election party, I did not vlog a lot of that, but I will definitely make sure I get the ones that I did vlog. And that was really, really good, really, really cool. I did notice, you know, I'm so self-aware, not bragging, like I'm not trying to brag in a way that's like, oh my God, I'm so self-aware, but it is a blessing and a curse. When I tell you, like, when you're constantly thinking about the things you did wrong or right, that is definitely, it takes a toll on you sometimes. Because sometimes it's just like, chill, it ain't that serious. But yesterday or last night, I won't get into like too many details because it's kind of personal, but I just felt myself in some of my interactions be a little petty, petty as in P-E-T-T-Y, and just not as gracious as I would want to be, as I would like to be. It is really coming down. And so I wasn't happy with myself about that. I am noticing, because I'm spending so much more time alone working, at home, at a coffee shop, whatever, even if I'm out like that, I'm still like, know, anti, I'm not so being social. And so since that's a natural part of who I am, I find myself in, you know, these social settings that I'm familiar with, and I'm like super familiar, like I'm super comfortable, and I may say things that I've gotta like, wait, is this the right place to say that? You know, I guess my energy is like, oh, finally I can let out and interact with these people. So thinking about that on this drive, thinking about this whole shelf situation that happened. And you, I mean, when you think about, oh, a shelf fell down in your house, okay. But if you know me, you know that I really am serious about my space. And so I'm really upset at the holes, the big gaping holes in my walls right now. I'm upset. You know, that I have to deal with it. It's in my workspace, so it's, you know, not like I can like put it off and kind of ignore it. I saw that it kind of like broke a little bit of my table, which I love my table. So there's like little things that really make me upset about it happening. I don't know why it happened, other than, you know, the shelf in with were not sturdy enough, or they didn't find the studs to make sure that they were in there. And so yeah, I just feel like I am way more, especially in this type of thing, it's like, okay, Kayla, wait, you have to ask yourself, what is this really about? You know, and I have a come to Jesus moment where I ask him, Lord, what is this really about? Why am I so obsessed? So upset. And it was more of like, okay, Kayla, really realizing like I was upset, and I, you know, I started to cry, and I was like, hold on, wait a second, where is this coming from? You know, this whole emotional over, just feeling overly emotional. And so I was like, okay. And so I thought to myself, I'm like, oh, this is the same thing that I dealt with when I first moved in. And I was just so tired. I was so tired. You know, decorating is one thing. and, you know, putting things and concepts and colors together is another thing. But I'm trying to think. I had movers bring in my belongings, the things that I did end up keeping. And then after that, you know, and I got rid of a lot of stuff in my apartment. And then after that, that was it. Everything else was put up, unpacked, you know, by me. And so whether that be at Home Goods, fitting a rug from, you know, the front of my car to the back of my car to get it home, bringing it up 2-3 flights of stairs, you know, unpacking these chairs that I've got from offline, putting the chairs together, putting them where they need to be, you know, bringing those boxes or those chairs. I would unpack as much as I could down on the third level or the first level and bring them up to the second and third, like already assembled or at least just the parts. And so all of that, like every single piece of my house was brought up, put up, screwed in, etc. by me. There's a mirror that my uncle and a friend did, or a guy I was dating did. And then there's this shelf that my uncle and my this guy did. And so I am just like, I remember feeling when I moved in how like just pitiful. Like I had a pity party around the fact that I didn't have help, that I had this house, that I had the ability to afford the house, that I had the ability to decorate and furnish it myself, and that I had to do all of this alone. I just felt those feelings coming up again, not as overwhelming and not as like, you know, as before, but definitely those types of feelings again. It's like, Lord, where is my husband? That's a real feeling to have. And you know, I'm always trying to look at the positive sides of things and then say to myself, like, thank you, Lord, for the ability to have my legs and the ability to have my eyes and my strength and everything so that I can put these things together for myself and be independent. And then I'm also looking at it just now as I'm talking, I'm like, you know what? It's a blessing that I'm not so independent that I don't realize that there is space and there is this room for a man in my life. Because there was a time where I don't think I really had room or was not conscious of the room I had for someone to fill. And so in order to, you know, have a good, healthy relationship, each person needs to feel needed. And there is for sure need in my life. So it's weird that I have that kind of like thought around that. That's absolutely growth. Again, I'm talking through this like I'm in a therapy session because I can't afford therapy right now. But I also feel like it's important for me to realize, like, yes, Kayla, God hasn't forgotten about you. You are growing in the ability to make sure there's real estate. I call it real estate. There's square footage available for the man that God is preparing for you. And yet, you can take care of this yourself for now. You know what I mean? I think that's the sweet spot of being content in your singleness. And without giving up the hope of marriage, without, you know, having a negative attitude towards the possibility of marriage. And it's a maturity thing because, again, I remember being at points where I had no room for a man or space for a man. And it's a mental thing as well, just having the ability to recognize that there's something, there's space in your life for a man. But also, I used to think, like, I'm probably not going to get married. I would say that out loud. I would declare that over my life, knowing that I wanted to be married, knowing I wanted this. But because I was frustrated with the process, I was frustrated with the process of maturing. I was frustrated with the process of dating and having failed dating attempts and failed relationships. Frustrated with all of that, that frustration turned into, and I allowed it to turn into this attitude where I don't need a man. I'm okay. Because, you know, you get tired of having those types of feelings. But when you're honest and self-aware with yourself and know what you want and have faith enough to know that God is working in the ways that you've asked him to work in your life, he's working in the ways that are for your good. When you truly believe that, you really don't have the option to kind of wallow and not be honest with yourself. You want to be honest with yourself so that God can give you the things that you're being honest with yourself with, if that makes sense, right? It's like, yes, Lord, I do need these things. Ask and you shall receive. If you don't know what to ask for because you were out here pretending like you have everything together, then sis, you're not gonna be able to get what you want. I'm so reckless when I drive, y'all. It's a hot mess. So yeah, that's a revelation I had. Now hopefully now that I've decompressed through that, I can, you know, focus on this program. I have boxes to pack. I have to pack for a wedding that I'm in. I have a lot of things. When I say boxes to pack, there are so many different things a part of that process that are very stressful. So I'm definitely being mindful of my breathing today. I'm definitely being mindful of where my thoughts are going today, because it can absolutely be overwhelming and feel like everything is on my plate. And honestly, a lot of it is. I mean, I'm not going to front. A lot of this is on my plate, especially when it comes to fulfilling and actually getting the product out to the customer. And so being honest about that, knowing I can do it, that I have time, that I have the ability to do this. I don't have a full-time job where I can't do it. All blessings. All blessings. So yeah, let's get this popping. Let's get this day in the books and let's make it a good